Some may be asking the question of, we went to the moon decades ago, why would we be going again? But the big picture here, right, of the Artemis program is not just to get to the moon. And by the way, very significant that it will be the first woman, the first person of color to step foot on the moon. But also this is about, eventually, this is about Mars, right? And getting to Mars. Can you explain how the two are tied together and how the moon helps with Mars?
Well, I want to separate it a little bit first.
Sure.
Going back to the moon in and of itself and establishing a permanent presence is something that's very important in and of itself. And that means that you're able to do observations, astronomical observations, see the Earth. You can also do things that have to do with manufacturing. So there's a lot to do just by being on the moon itself in a permanent way. Now, it also gives you an opportunity to practice some of the things that are needed for long duration deep space flights, like going to Mars. And that is understanding the radiation, understanding what happens to humans in these different kinds of gravitational environments. It also gives you, at the way this is set up, a gateway station for even constructing the vehicle outside of the Earth orbit. So this is a really interesting mechanism to go to Mars. And then people might ask, why do you want to go to Mars? Well, you know, it's our closest neighboring planet. But the other part of it is we have so much to learn about the geology of Mars. We have so much to learn about what happens to planets and their atmospheres. So doing that is critically important as well. So the moon is a base that's important in and of itself, but it helps facilitate going to Mars.
And Jonathan, reading about the experiments planned for the moon, I mean, technology has obviously advanced enormously in the last 50 years. I've been reading about things like they're going to cryogenically freeze some samples on the moon surface to bring them back. They're going to test in areas that are not, that don't encounter the sun, you know, things that they weren't able to do in the late 60s and early 70s. Does that have scientific, or how much, I should say, scientific importance does that have?
Yeah, I think it's very interesting. And really, it all ties into learning to live off the Earth. So I think the real implication is, as Dr. Jemison said, you know, we want to go to a future where there are humans throughout the solar system. The moon is like, if anything goes wrong on the moon, you're only a few days from home. So it's a lot better to practice there than to go to Mars right away. And the Apollo missions could only land in a very few areas of the moon, near the moon's equator. This time we're going to go back and land near the lunar south pole, which is a very exciting area scientifically and a very exciting area for future moon bases, because we think it has the frozen water locked up in the rock.